Life Matters continues on Lake 96.1, sponsored by Mercy Health System, with all our heart, with all our mind, and Home Helpers In-Home Care Assistance, making life easier.
This is Life Matters on Lake 96.1. There are so many fantastic causes in our area every year, but fall seems to be the time of year where a lot of those causes come front and center. One of those causes is the Walk for Africa, which is taking place on Saturday, October 10th. We have a couple of people, well, one in studio, one on the phone to talk a little bit more about that event. First of all, Michelle Weisheim, did I say that correctly?
You sure did.
Michelle, good morning.
Good morning.
And on the phone this morning is Carrie Reichartz, who is so dedicated to this cause, she's literally talking to us from the airport right now in Milwaukee. Hi, Carrie.
Good morning.
The big question before we get to the important issue, have you found your luggage?
Not yet. We'll deal with that after.
Fair enough. Carrie, talk a little bit about the Walk for Africa and the big event that's coming up on Saturday.
Absolutely. We have our Walk for Africa coming up. It kind of was inspired, or it was inspired by many trips to Kenya. I've been to Kenya about 15 times. And on one of my first few trips, I was really feeling inspired to do something to raise awareness for how people live in Kenya, you know, living in mud huts, having to walk 3 miles for water, not having access to education, you know, all those types of things. And it was just really laid on my heart that I needed to do something. I didn't know what that was. I'm not even a runner, never was a runner, really. But I felt like this was a way that a lot of people could come together for a good cause and raise some money. And every little bit makes such a huge difference. We can feed a child 2 times a day for a month for $5.
Wow.
So, like, very, very little bits of money can go a huge, huge way in Africa. So every little bit helps so much. We feed and school them for $25 a month. And my pet project in all of this is a pregnancy crisis center that we're working on there.
Now, tell us a little bit about how you found out about the issues with regard to needing this pregnancy shelter.
Yes, I'm a lawyer by trade, and so when I was in Kenya, I would make a lot of trips and talk to lawyers and different pastors and government officials, and so other people like that. And when I looked back and wrote my book, From Lawyer to Missionary, A Journey to Kenya and Back Again, I really realized that in all those conversations with them, that kept coming up. There's nowhere for these girls to go. They're kicked out of their homes, they're kicked out of their schools, and there's just nowhere for them to go. And so they don't have food. They don't have anything. Of course, they have to turn to desperate measures, you know, prostitution and sex trafficking and things like that, because they don't have any other options. And so that really pressed on my heart. And so that's kind of the direction that most of my work is focused. So I work on all fronts, the kids at the schools, and we have a medical clinic as well. And so.
So this helps curb that vicious circle, because that's what happens is that they get kicked out of their homes. They have to turn to something, you know, like you said, you know, often it's sex trafficking. You know, they're trying to find somebody to take care of them, to help them, you know, survive on their own. They get pregnant. They could be prosecuted. They definitely can't take care of another human being. The babies get abandoned, you know, and so this is to pull them out of that vicious circle.
Absolutely, absolutely. And it's a place, it's a live-in facility. They'll come and live there. We will train them depending on their age. We may get them into school, or we may train them in a trade, or both, just depending on the situation. A lot of times families, once the baby is born, will accept them back into the home. But then we would also work with the families to try and get some income into those families to feed the child as well as the mom. So that's one of our major focuses. We also work with an orphanage over there called Baby Life Rescue, and they do a lot of adoption, which in Kenya is not very prevalent. It's not very society accepted. And so they've been doing a lot of education on that, and they do a lot of work in that area to get domestic adoptions accomplished. And so they didn't have any support, and so that's part of the proceeds from this run also go to help them feed the orphans that they have in their care so they are able to keep them long enough to get them adopted. So
saving the children, basically.
Yes, absolutely.
And you can help do that by taking part in the 5K that's coming up this Saturday at South Shore Park Pavilion. That's in Milwaukee. The event is a 5K. People hear 5K, uh-oh, I'm not ready to partake in something like that just now. We're just coming off the summer season. It's a 5K. It's not a race. At the end of the day, you're getting outside. Let's be honest, early October weather is beautiful.
It is called Walk for Africa.
Well, no.
So we don't have to run,
exactly.
Right?
Not like the Kenyans do in the Boston Marathon.
It's not a race.
It is the Kenyans. Yes, it is.
We actually do have two different paths, one for walkers and one for runners. So people that want to run, they're free to run, and they're kind of out of the way. And then we have our walkers path, which is closer to the lakefront. So.
Now, Michelle, you're involved in this. Tell us, now, first of all, you're Mrs. Racine County as well.
That is correct.
Is that how?
Dang it, we didn't put the red carpet out. Sorry.
I know.
My bad.
She forgot the crown. I don't know why. So is that how you got involved with this walk, with this organization?
I did. I got to know Carrie through a good friend of mine, and she was currently doing her school supply drive and her toy drive to bring things down to the children in Kenya. And I brought the idea home to my husband and our three girls. They went nuts. They ran downstairs and bagged up a bunch of stuff that they could, made individual little bags, and Carrie took them to Kenya.
Aww.
Carrie then took pictures. So my children and my husband got to see what it's like down there, how they live, and that touched us very much. So from now on, we actually have a box downstairs in our basement that every time we're going to throw something away, one of those little children of mine remind me, let's put that in the box for our Kenyan kids.
Nice.
Aww.
Yeah. They're pretty sweet creatures.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So you're participating in the walk. Tell us how we register. How do we, if we want to come out and take, first of all, it's in a beautiful area.
Yes.
Again, in the fall at a beautiful time.
Yes. What you can do is you can actually go to KenyaGiveHope.com and you can register there, and you can do that, and it's $35. The day of the event, it's actually going to be $40. So you want to register soon so that way you can save a little bit of money. And one thing that I really like about the walk that's coming up is it's going to be more than just a walk. It's going to be kind of like a little festival. We're going to have traditional Kenyan food, which most people are not able to try.
Ooh.
I am very excited to try it.
What does that mean?
Define, yeah,
what is Kenyan food?
Carrie has...
Carrie, tell us.
I'm curious.
Yes, there'll be little samosas there, which are... A lot of Kenyan food has an Indian influence.
Did you say mimosas?
The samosas are little...
Ooh, mimosas,
pockets.
We're in. No, that's not what she said. She did not say
okay.
Mimosas.
I heard mimosas.
No, samosas.
Samosas.
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah, and they're little triangles that of bread that are filled with, it depends, sometimes they're meat, sometimes they're potatoes and veggies. I'm not sure which ones we're going to have there, maybe both. And they're delicious. We'll also have some rice, various forms of rice, jerk chicken, I think lentil soup. So there'll be a lot of different things depending on the temperature, too, what you might be interested in.
Ooh.
And I will try it.
Will you?
I will. I promise my kids and my husband that I will try it. And I
excellent.
Will.
Excellent.
So, yeah, register right away when you can. It's at South Shore Pavilion on the 10th of October. And in addition to the Kenyan food that we talked about, there's going to be crafts. There's going to be silent auctions, items to buy. There's going to be things for the kids to do, too. So the whole family's more than welcome to come.
And think about how, I mean, that's just very... It's very inexpensive to participate in this. But think about how far your money goes. Because, Carrie, you said $5... feeds a child twice a day for a month?
Yes, every school day. Yes.
Wow. Yeah. See, I
yeah.
mean, that's...
So seven kids get to eat that wouldn't otherwise eat. So, yeah, absolutely.
That's incredible. That's absolutely incredible. So what's the website again?
It is KenyaGiveHope.com. And then up in your right-hand corner, there'll be a link where you can register to the website.
Okay. Can you register just yourself? Can you bring teams? You can bring as many people as you
like,
I suppose.
You can bring as many people as you want, as long as you pay that entry fee and you get your shirt. You guys can walk and run with us.
Families are welcome. Now, is that $40 per person? How does that work, Carrie, if you want to bring your family?
If it's adult shirts, so if you want a shirt, then you have to register.
Gotcha.
So we do not have child-sized shirts, so I would not register your children. And then the other things that are down there, silent auction, other things are there whether you're running or not. So we have special things for our runners with coffee and juice and donuts and all that kind of thing for our runners only. But there are also other things. You can purchase some handmade Kenya items there as well as the food and all of that, even if you don't register for the run. Those are separate purchases.
Let's talk a little bit about Kenya Cultural Explosion Night. We could come and meet you and find out what turned you from a lawyer into a missionary in 10 days. Talk a little bit about that, where it's at. That's this week, coming up on Wednesday, right?
Yes, that is coming up at the Muskego Library on Wednesday, October 7th. that starts at 6:30. We, again, will have our crafts there. We'll have a little Kenyan food, not a lot, but a little snack of Kenyan food that will not be at the run, available for people. It's about an hour, hour and a half presentation. We go through various slides, what life is like in Kenya, my journeys to Kenya and back again, and then just ways to make a difference in the world, be that with Operation Give Hope, our organization, or anything else, to just take advantage of every moment and different ways to do that, and just hearing stories of people doing that. So.
You know, there's so many people that are homeschooling their kids these days, and that's what the flyer says. It's great for homeschoolers and anyone wanting, you know, and travel enthusiasts, of course, but anyone wanting to hear stories of what life is like in other places in the world. And I think that people who, you know, who have traveled as much as you to a particular area and then turned around and you've put it into words in your book, that is very, very important for young people to hear and almost be mentored by, because so many people do not get out and travel the world. And, you know, like this says, the kids that are homeschooled, even if they're not, just to sit down and listen to those experiences many, many times is life changing at a young age.
Yeah, it's awesome. And I do, if we have kids in the crowd, I do kind of gear it towards kids. It's kind of geared that way anyway, just because it's so new to all of us over here.
Sure.
I didn't know where Kenya was before I went the first time. I had no idea where it was. So I'm in that same boat with everyone else, that it's like just kind of learning where it is, what culture is like, what do they eat, what do they, you know, how do they live, you know, just all of that kind of stuff. It's just, it's really fun. It's exciting. It's great for kids. It's great for adults. We have young and old that are at these events, and they're really fun events.
So that is Wednesday night, and then, of course, the Walk for Africa is coming up this weekend. Michelle, one more time, how do we register?
Go to KenyaGiveHope.com, upper right-hand corner. It'll send you right to the link, $35, and then the day of the run, it'll be $40.
Carrie Reichhardt's joining us from Mitchell International Airport, and, of course, did you find your baggage yet? Carrie?
Not yet. Right. I got to go to the desk.
Well, appreciate your time this morning. Again, best of luck with the event coming up on Wednesday in Mesquite, then, of course, the run. All that information, again, is on our website, late961.com. Make sure to check out the Life Matters page for more details. Michelle, appreciate you being in studio. And,
Thank you.
And appreciate your family with the donations in the basement, right?
Everyone
needs a box like that at the end
That's
of the day.
That's a great idea.
Thank you, guys.
We'll continue with Life Matters in 2 minutes on Lake 96.1. 96.1.